Hasn't it been one jam-packed week in the Aussie jungle with hard-hitting conversations, terrifying trials, as well as fantastic life drawing from Poe? You really don't know what to expect in the I'm a Celebrity jungle. And this morning, we are joined by the fabulous host, Julia Morris, who joins us live from Melbourne. Hello, lady. It's great to see you. This year, there's just so much to be proud about with this show. Fantastic, big-hearted, deep conversations happening in the camp. The trials are terrifying as well. Are you surprised how the celebrities have gone in scoring stars?
I am always flabbergasted every single trial because I always think when those celebrities are standing in front of me, it's I'm only one bad tweet away from being on the other side of this scenario. My empathy is deep and strong. And what they put themselves through for their team members, I always stand there thinking, oh, no, I don't think I'd do that for others. I mean, I do loads for others. But there's something that rises within our celebrities to, yeah, I suppose they've turned up to play, so that's what they're going to do. But, my gosh, do they come face-to-face with, like, even the most stoic of us would be rattled by some of those trials?
Oh, they're bringing it.
Most definitely. We love this show in our house. And the dynamic of the group has been superb so far. There have been some huge conversations, Julia, happening in the camp this year. Toddy Goldsmith, she was speaking for the first time about getting caught up in that drug scandal, while Maria, who we just spoke to, she opened up about her sexuality. What do you think it is about the jungle that allows the celebrities to open up so much and share and feel comfortable?
It turns down the noise on your life. And if there's something that you want, everyone has their own headlines, don't we? We're like, you know, this is the sort of person I am and this is how I feel about vaccine. And, you know, we've all got our little headlines. And this is an opportunity to get a real cut-through voice on, you know, on television, straight into homes. And the interesting thing about this group of people is there's no fighting. So we've seen loads of fighting on TV. We get it. Unreal. Okay. I find it very stressful. So when you're going to get a group that's as cohesive and there's a, you know, pretty high level of intelligence that's running through this group, then I genuinely, even as a 53-year-old turning 54-year-old woman, I feel like I'm learning things from their bravery to share. I'm like, wow, you're definitely on the television. The problem with sharing the honesty, and I've got no problem with being honest, you know, as much as I possibly can, is that every single interview for the rest of your life, someone's going to ask you about how you feel about your mother dying. Do you know what I mean? So it just invites this weirdness in the door where you're talking with some featured extra that you've just not invested in and they ask you the deepest question that you could possibly answer and you're expected to share in the style of honesty. So these guys opening up, it's not just brave that they're talking about it on telly. It definitely has a knock-on effect through their lives because everything they talk about in the jungle definitely gets asked about forever.
Yeah, there's something so powerful about seeing these celebrities so kind of pared back and vulnerable as well. This week, the celebs, Jules, received their luxury items. If you were in the jungle, what would be your luxury item? And you can't say Chris Brown.
Oh, I mean, that would... OK, if I can't have my number one choice. What would it... I think it would be... get-out-of-jail-free card. I think my luxury item would be at least one night a week in a hotel. No, I'm much higher than that. I'm only joking. What would be my luxury item? I don't know. Maybe... who knows? Maybe just a little pillow.
No treats you'd smuggle in there?
I wouldn't be that organised. I'd be like, why didn't I get the loved ones on the boat, on the stupid pillow?
Julia, what can you tell us about Sunday? There's going to be the first... I don't want to see anyone go, but it's going to be the first elimination on Sunday. Is there anything you can tell us about it?
It's always a sad day when we lose a camp member because, as we can see, there really is not a weak link in this chain. Nope. So every time someone goes, there is an interesting knock-on effect through camp. Some relationships kind of reform because the best pal's gone or whatever. And, of course, because Australians aren't voting, it's done as fairly as possible. They compete against each other. And, honestly, some nights you're just not up to it and other nights you are. And on the nights that you are, you get to stay another night in the jungle. So that's what's making it so fascinating is it's literally anybody's game because you can, you know, drop off your perch because you can't work out how many scorpions are in a box, which is completely fine. And that's the way you leave the jungle. I don't think that's the way the person leaves the jungle. And if it is on Sunday night, I'm already in trouble. But now how they're feeling, how strong they're feeling on the night as to whether they are going to last another week. So it's not in years gone by where it wasn't someone who didn't contribute as much, or it's none of that. It's, you know, at least it's fair.
We love it.
We are loving it. We can't wait to see who the first celebrity to exit the camp will be. I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here continues Sunday night, 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Julia, we know you're very busy. Thank you for taking the time to chat with us today. We love you. We'll see you soon.
Anytime. Love you. Kenny's here beside me having a little bone, so he's being very well behaved. He is.
Aww.
But he's literally...
There's your little fella.
There he is.
Oh, baby.